So it's absolutely fantastic, really. It goes perfectly together. So in Cold Card, you plug it into a power-only supply, like power bank or direct electricity socket out of the wall. And then you start it up, you write down your seed and everything. You can do encrypted backups on the SD cards and all good, right? Passphrases and everything done on the Cold Card, all that you want to do, it's awesome. So you put in an SD card and you select, I don't know the exact path, but then it's select Wasabi Wallet. I think it's SD card and then export skeleton Wasabi Wallet file. And that will put a like really short TXT, I think it's TXT file, on the SD card. And I've put the exact one in Slack a couple weeks back. And then the user puts this into the wallet's folder. I so far did it manually. Of course, it would be perfect if in Wasabi there is a little button that in the wallet creation section, like import wallet, and that then pops up a window to show like the file system where you can then select the SD card, double click on that public key file with master fingerprint and everything, and click on import, and then it automatically changes that short little file into the regular Wasabi wallet file as we know it, or like regularly. And it already does that, and it did that already 5 weeks ago. So that's fantastic. That actually works, and everything gets restructured. And then you have a watch-only wallet in Wasabi, and you can easily select the UTXOs and in the advanced tabs build the PSBT transaction. Currently, you get that PSBT in hex and in, I think, just clear text as well. I don't know, or a JSON file or something. I'm not sure. But there is an issue here that Cold Card actually needs the binary format of the PSBT. And I don't know if they will implement the hex format. Maybe probably not. So it might be easier just to change that in Wasabi. To just display the binary as well, and then currently there's also only shows these things. You have to manually select that all, and then to copy it, and to build a file, and to paste that in, and then to like name the file accordingly. So it would be best to again have a button that is export PSBT. That then again opens the file manager where you can specify a name, and there's like a standard of transaction, maybe the label with it, .psbt, and you copy or you save that directly on the SD card. You unplug the SD card, plug that SD card again in the power-only Cold Card, and here you click on the menu, very first one on sign, and it will automatically detect that there is a PSBT somewhere on that SD card. It doesn't need to be a special folder or anything, just like root or like base a repository in the on that SD card, and it will automatically detect it. Then the user can verify everything that is in that PSBT, and he sees everything that's important in on the very large screen. And then he checks it and signs the transaction. And then there are two transactions being saved on that SD card. That is one, the signed, partially signed Bitcoin transaction in the .psbt file. And then the other one is a final transaction in a TXT file, I believe. Might be a different file type. And then you import that SD card back into the laptop. And now in the broadcast tab, currently, again, there's only a way to paste a signed transaction. Would be cool to have the button with import signed transaction, or directly call it broadcast signed transaction. And here then you select most likely the signed final transaction, because you don't have to change anything here. You literally just have to plug that out and broadcast it over Tor. Or you could, of course, also import the signed PSBT transaction and then do some internal, I don't know, maybe some additional checks, and then locally in Wasabi build the final signed transaction and broadcast that out. There, I'm not sure what's best for the Wasabi workflow, but both should work pretty much. And that's it, completely offline, completely private. The very cool thing is that for Cold Card, the only reason to have Cold Card is that you don't have to plug it into a computer, so that even your extended public key is never released to any internet connection. And the cool thing is with Wasabi being BIP-158 block filters, we have that exact same property. So cold card and Wasabi go perfectly together because both have a huge focus on the privacy of public keys as well.